Often there are times when we need to include a picture or a logo on our model and engrave or emboss it. We're going to trace a logo onto this cardboard packaging. Now this method works with any high quality picture or logo. First, we'll start a new sketch on our desired face. Under Tools and Sketch Tools, we'll select the Sketch Picture command. We'll then browse to and open our logo. It's best to use a high quality image to ensure that we have crisp lines to trace. In the Sketch Picture Property Manager, we can flip our image along its X and Y axes and resize and position it on our model. There are two ways to do this. The first uses the Scale tool to measure a line on the image and assign that line a dimension. The image then scales by the scale factor of the measurement. We can drag the image and scale tool handles to move and rotate the image. The second way of resizing the image is by using the property boxes. We can specify X and Y coordinates from the origin, as well as a rotation and horizontal and vertical proportions. Now that we have our image positioned and sized, we can trace it. We'll trace our logo manually with a series of sketch lines and splines, as the Autotrace add-in leaves rather a lot to be desired, even from a high-quality, simple image. Using the line tool, we'll trace the straight edges, assigning a few relations and sketch dimensions to hold them in place as we go. The spline tool is the most effective way of tracing these curves accurately. Now we want to create seamless curves, so let's add some tangent relations between the curves and each connecting straight line. This will ensure a smooth transition as we go around the shape. We'll start with as few spline points as possible to allow for simpler curves. And if we need to, we'll add more as we go, enabling the display control polygons from the right-click menu for increased control. Let's round off the edges of the logo with a sketch fillet and extrude a shallow cut into the cardboard. We can then assign the printed appearance to the cut to give it a realistic professional look.